What's up, Auburn family? I'm on the way to Auburn, Alabama for the very first time in well over a year since the beginning of the 2020 pandemic. We'll be spending some time during an 8-day weekend here. Today is Saturday, so it's game day. And I'm going to be going to the game today, spend a little time on campus, hopefully meeting some podcast listeners. So excited to be back on the loveliest village on the plains. There's a lot to see and do that's new there since everything's been shut down. So I'm excited to see the plains again. So hope you enjoy the ride. We're here on campus now, finally. It's 10 o'clock. It's still very quiet. I'm heading towards Sanford Lawn just to kind of get a feel for the morning and being back on campus for the first time in forever. And probably gonna go over here and check out this new, if they're serving it yet, this new raspberry lemonade over at Toomer's Corner. I saw it on social media the other day, had to go try it. So let's go check it out. So I had to sit down and take a few more sips of this, just try to, you know, gauge where it's at on my level of Toomer's lemonade love. It's still good, but I prefer the strawberries one because they actually chop up strawberries, and this is actually some type of like raspberry flavoring they throw in there with the lemonade, and you can clearly like tell the mixture. Whereas the strawberries is there's a clear difference, and there's actually strawberry pieces in it. So while I would probably tell people to get the strawberry lemonade still, I will get this again someday. But in order of my favorites, how I'd rank them, strawberry lemonade at Toomer's Corner, then the regular lemonade, and then this one. Still good though, so you should definitely try it and see if you like it. So one of the things is they've been testing the audio system since I arrived at about like a little before 9 this morning. So you can like already hear, it feels like a game day almost if there were more people because of the music that's playing like throughout all the campus. And probably it feels that way because you can hear it throughout all of the campus because there's not that many people here. So I don't think we're gonna have a huge turnout today, even with the limited capacity. Just doesn't feel like it. So no A-Day pins at the Bay Bookstore, which is really surprising. I thought they normally did that thing. And I guess maybe it's COVID-19 protocol stuff. But sad day, it's like a tradition for me. Go pick up the A-Day pin and, you know, it's like part of the day that checks off the boxes. So who knows, maybe we'll have them back in football season. As I suspected, it's pretty dead here. Not a lot of people all together. Showing up, but still should be fun. It's A-Day, it's football. We didn't have it last year, so I'm thankful.
The 2021 roster, list of football award winners, and other useful information that will add to the enjoyment of today's game.
I want you to appreciate how high I'm going up. I'm in the walkway, it's going all the way up to section 61. It's like the highest point too, I think, in this thing. I haven't had to walk up this far in such a long time.
Hey,
Each week during football season, Yellowwood honors the game's outstanding linemen as selected by the Auburn coaching staff on the Auburn Football Everyday Television Show. At the end of the season, players were selected as the Yellowwood Lineman of the Year.
I'm up here in section 61. You can kind of see it's at the very end of the deck. It's pretty spread out up here. It's actually kind of nice, I'm not gonna lie. The sun's come out, it's a little bit bright, but it's not a bad view for everything going on. I'll probably move down later in the game.
Oh, you ready? Count them, 1, 2, 3. Track them, Tigers, just like me. Give them hell, you more than evil.
There was a fumble on the play.
So we're at halftime and they're doing a punt pass kick contest with two students, one from Wetumpka, one from Birmingham. First guy didn't do so good. Second guy's not doing all that great either. But hey, look, they're students, they're not football players. But first half observations, Bo Nix looks a lot better. Offensive line looked a little better at times, but not outstanding. Defense seems to be pretty good, decently. And then Elijah Canyon had a great pass catch from Bo Nix in the touchdown. So they just made a made his pass portion of his contest. So now he's going down there to kick. Let's see if he makes it. I'm going to critique him because I used to be a kicker. He made it. Attaboy. That was pretty good for him. Pretty good for him. Not bad. Not bad. Halftime right now. Still, it's getting hot outside. It's a great day to be out here for a day.
Pat Bixby returns from.
thoughts for Spring A Day as it just wrapped up, and you can hear in the background the alma mater being played. It was different. It really was. Not just because this was COVID-19, first spring game after that. There's no fan autograph session, time to go down the field or any of that. But it was different in the terms of just everything. Not a lot happened in the second half other than Demetrius Davis. Really great throw. He also almost threw a pick six as well, which I think people are going to miss because they're real hyped about it. But it was a great throw by him. Excited to see what he can do. But yeah, happy it went, happy it happened, and we'll see what happens. It's just a spring game. Much more to come next fall.